right, welcome to Athenaeum-ish, and let me get everything all sorted out. And just as a quick introduction, my name is Lorin. Today I'm going to play a game. This is really kind of an experimental stream, and I'm really just starting it, I think, this evening in earnest. And so I think it's going to be a bit of a variety stream. I may talk about the things that I'm working on in school. I may watch a bad public domain movie. I may watch or play a game. So I think this is just going to be evolving as I move forward with this stream. So I am a first-time gamer, really, so it's not really something that I've done very much, and I'd like to get accustomed to the culture. So right now I've been trying to familiarize myself with the classics, I suppose, so to speak. And I'm not really into shoot 'em up games. My reflexes aren't as good yet. I'm hoping that I'll get better at it. So I think for now I'm gonna stick with maybe more quieter, more exploratory games. And of course, if anyone is in chat, if you have any recommendations, that would be really cool. But let me go ahead and start with the game. And this evening I'm going to try my first playthrough of Dear Esther. I heard a lot about it, and it sounds like something that I would like. So let me get everything geared up to get ready to play. And let me make sure that everything is all working, and here we go. There's Dear Esther, and I'm going to go ahead and get started. And I did start this so that I could figure out how to move around in the game, but my first impressions are that it's really atmospheric and beautiful. I have it set on the director's comments, and I'm thinking that I might not want to do that, so let me go in and change that. I think it's the audio. Let's see. Maybe not. It's so funny. It always... options, language. That's not it. Let's see. Okay, two speakers, disabled, done. See, let me try keyboard mouse. No. And we may just be ending up listening to it because I can't remember which setting it was. But I'm gonna give myself like 5 more seconds just to see what's going on. Let's see. Let me go to advanced. No. Display mode, no. This is really interesting when you get into the really advanced stuff. Let's see. I'm gonna try one more thing. Nope. Which one did I not push? Okay, well, I guess I'm stuck with that. Let me head back. One last thing. Okay, well, it's not doing anything, so I guess I'll just finally give up and just start again. So, and I'm thinking I'll go to the house and still getting used to controlling my mouse. The desolation is so beautiful. I live in a really, really sunny place, and so when it's rainy like this, it really feels like something special. And I guess we'll go into the house. Wow, that's gross. At least I have a flashlight, so there's that. Okay. This is really a wreck. It looks like it's been abandoned for a long time. Way that I can get close into that? See what I can do. Oh, that looks like a map. See, what else can I do here? And it always takes me forever to figure this stuff out, so let me see if I can look at the options and the controller. Okay, so loop type normal. I'm still getting used to driving this thing. Okay, so zoom in. Okay, so mouse one. I'm not sure what that means. Mouse one, mouse zero. Let's see what I can do. Okay, left shift. I think that'll be a little bit easier. So let me do that. Let me see if I can zoom in to see resume game. Let me see if I can zoom into that. And they said it was a left shift, so I don't know that I can do anything to it yet. See if I can zoom into that route planner. Okay, so I guess we're in Britain. That's good to know. Some letters. There's a radiator. See where else I can go. Wow, okay. See, so that's food. Food and goods. Interesting. I like that they said that everything, well, every time that you play, it's a little bit different in terms of all the details and set dressing. Let's see, let's go into this part of the house. Okay, that's interesting. So, whoever it was doing some painting. It's a really interesting shape. That's interesting. I guess there's nothing that I can really focus on the floor. It looks like we have a couple of pathways to go. I'm not sure whether to try the high path or the low path. See if it'll let me walk over here. This is so beautiful. Okay, so I see something in the distance. I don't know what it is yet. This is really, really beautiful. The level of detail is gorgeous. Okay, well, I don't think I want to commit suicide just yet, so. But this seems like it would be a really good place to stop and maybe sit on this rock and watch the sea and have a picnic. I guess I'll go ahead and take the lower the lower path. Let's see. The sea mist too is amazing. Okay, so there's some rocks. I think maybe I'm going in the right direction. I mean, I see the director or the creator's commentary rather. See if I can avoid it for now. This is so beautiful. I want to stop and take screenshots constantly. I guess those are things. I guess it's just trash. I was hoping it was something, some sort of clue. And again, I don't know very much about this game, so. It's interesting. I wonder if you can go in the water. Let's see. Well, I guess I'm floating on it. Okay. Oh, okay. Maybe these are fish traps or something like that. Let's see what the creators say. So this is talking about the music. I think I'm going to go back to the house. Let me get back on the path. Okay. See if I can avoid that one. Multiple story units. That's interesting. Oh, okay. I didn't even realize that that was a lighthouse. See, that's a cliff. There's the boat. See, I wonder how we get to the lighthouse. Let's see. Let me figure this out. We go indoors. party was in there. I wonder if we can open this door. Okay. Oh, there's the stairs. I wonder how we would get up there. Let's see. No idea. That appears to be a door. I don't even know how to, let's see, how do you make things interact on this thing? Let's see. So let me go to options and keyboard mouse. Okay, so we can do the reverse mouse, but let's see, edit keys, buttons, okay. Zoom in, move forward. The one thing that confuses me is I'm not sure how people are supposed to interact with the game. I wonder if I do left shift, I can get closer. Or if you can walk straight in, just stops me from doing that. Let's see what else I can do. Oh, that is a very interesting diagram. It looks like some sort of structure, like an element or a compound of some kind, like chemistry. It seems like it would be a significant clue. See if I can go around. There we go again. Let's see. Go to, where's main menu? We need to cancel. I wonder if it's on the main menu where I have to like switch it off. Because it is starting to drive me crazy. Oh well. I wonder how far we can go over the hill. Like, I wonder if we can climb. See if I can get to where I was. Okay, well, it's letting me walk through. Okay, the path continues. I guess I was a little too timid after all. Oh, it's a cave. I wonder what is in here. Do I have a flashlight? Oh, it's a tunnel. This is so beautiful. I suppose this is how you get around to the back side of whatever that is. There's a light over there too. Well, This is so incredibly beautiful. I'm really entranced by it. There's more paint. Interesting. So I guess you have to really scamper. Oh. How irritating. So you do have to grab. That's irritating. If I go farther this way, I wonder if there's a way that I can climb. Though this seemed like it was a dead end. That was pretty smooth how you didn't fall screaming and die. So I'm really getting, oh, there's the stairs. I'm really getting some Wicker Man vibes from this. The music too. There's a paper up there. I see. So we are really in a very, very remote island. Okay, there's the rest of the path. Oh, okay. Let me see. It's really hard to tell though if I've gotten any farther. Hebrides. I've never said that word before out loud. It's really gorgeous, but at least I'm getting somewhere. Oh, now I have to stop and look. I wonder if there are milestones or maybe another type of standing stone. Let's see. Okay. This is really beautiful. So there's the second one. And I see another up in the distance. It's hard for me to tell if they're meant to be markers, or if they have another type of significance. There aren't very many items out here to look at. Just stones. And yet another. I see a cave in the distance. It would be nice to have a map of some form. I'm already pretty turned around. I suppose that the house must be back over yonder. Ah, there's a shipwreck though. Let's see if I can get past this one without triggering. The commentary, and of course I go for the dark, dangerous cave. Oh my, that is really beautiful. More of that. I suppose it was paint, glow in the dark paint, porcelain paint. These are really beautiful. Ah, that would be, I feel terrible because I'm forgetting what it is, but I know it's, isn't it a nerve or a type of brain cell? This shape, I don't quite I don't recognize it very well. I'm really curious what that could be. Another symbol. See, I'm gonna have to look up the word for it. So whoever lives here, obviously has some chemistry, science knowledge, biology. I wonder what the twist or the shock is going to be. I wonder if I can get to the wrecked boat somehow. We turn around. Okay, so the house is straight ahead, and I wonder if there's a pathway that I can find. No. Well, okay, obviously there's a path over there. Let me see how I can manage to get there. Look at this closely. Oh, silly me. There's a path over there that I missed. How could I be so nearsighted? Hmm. I wonder where this path is going to take me. So far, I know really very little about the inhabitants that left the drawings and that lived in the house. I have no idea what year this is, what type of person my character is. At least we know where we are geographically, but Sparta is pretty lovely. The whole game is lovely, but I keep being surprised at how beautiful things look and just all of the different features that they put in and details. I was walking in the stream. At least having the comments on gives me a little bit of a clue. Otherwise, I would be completely lost. I see. I was wondering about the stones above, and it looks like my suspicion, I wouldn't say right, but it's a type of mini, I wouldn't call it a Stonehenge, but standing stones, I think, is the word that they use for it. I can't tell what the pattern is supposed to be. And I see a few directions to go in. I can't decide whether to head left or right. Let me see if I can follow this small trickle of water. Doesn't appear to be a way to go. In that case, there's this path over here. Which probably leads to nowhere, but I'm hoping that eventually I'll be able to figure out where things are. This is getting a little bit ominous. Oh! Somehow I've stumbled into an achievement. Imagine that. The only thing that's missing is the sheep and any other livestock. Oh, but look. And what could that be? We'll take the right-hand path and descend into whatever that is. Is that the shipwreck that we saw earlier? It's hard to tell which way, but there's more objects here. cargo. What exactly can I find here? Well, the music sounds creepy. Will it let me go inside the boat though? Obviously not. See if I can walk through this crate. More drawings. That's interesting. Let me see if I can save this, because I'm actually gonna stop a little bit early. Cancel. How do we save this? That's depressing. Well, before I quit, I will say goodbye. Thank you, everyone. If anybody has been watching, hopefully the stream has been working. I guess I'll find out when I turn it off. And I will see y'all next Tuesday.